Hello everyone. So I'm back with another video for today. And today I have I'm going to be opening up my holiday Barbie. It's lady thing. A review on her. You can't really see her. Let me move the camera up. You can see her face full of cheers. I did open every doll that I had. Yes, I did. I sure did. I'm more of an out of the box collector. I'm sorry I didn't make a video, but I will make a video showing you each doll that I got. I'm going to show you each doll that I got after I'm done with her. But yeah, and I do plan on going to another antique store. So I was actually trying to go to another one today. I already kind of loosened the tape, so you loosen it over here. And also, it says at the bottom that there's a 5x7 copy picture of her, of this picture in a frame. So, I'm supposed to get this open. This is where everything is attached. And then just slide off. But here's the picture. Here's the picture that they mentioned. This is the same picture that's on the back of the box. So I'm really glad they included that. It's very costly, nice and shiny cardboard picture. And then we have a wonderful. One year limited warranty, and we have a happy holidays Barbie postcard or something. Yes.
All right, show me around. What is that over there?
Those are surveillance cameras.
Your name will be on file as official doll owner with Mattel. I'm guessing. Let me know what this is for. I'll show you this.
You can't buy one of anything.
You know that's the key right there. I don't want 20 by 12.
Right. I don't buy one. And there is a lot to undo. Is that her dress pulled up right there?
I don't know
what that is.
That's so, the understatement of the day.
This is going to take a while. I have to. I'm sorry, I'm almost lost in the TV. So, but I'm gonna do this review. This review the right way. Because there's a lot of tape, there's a lot of stuff that I have to undo. So this is gonna take a while. I'm gonna try to undo it faster than this, but it's gonna take a while. It's definitely gonna take a while. This is gonna take me a minute. See, this is old to tape. This doll is from 1993, by the way. Blonde hair ever. It's really soft. And she's got really pink, actually. She's a pink skin tone. She has this beautiful dress on. you see a close up picture of her. And then, like, instantly killing. So.
Well, it's very
she's very pretty. Look at her. She's got the softest hair ever. And she's kind of got everything. So I'm going to continue to try and free her from her. From her prison. See, I'm out of the box collector. I don't really believe in keeping dolls in a box because it's like they Barbies weren't made to be kept in a box. They were made to be taken out and played with. And some people just really kind of annoy me with that whole she's brand new in the box. And like, only reason I see to keep a doll brand new in a box is unless you're planning on selling her. If you're not selling her, you're keeping her for yourself. What's the point of keeping her in a box? I don't understand that. Like, what's the point? If you're keeping her for yourself, why do you have her in a box? You know? That's not what Barbies were made for. They were made to be taken out and played with. No matter how old they are. That was her purpose. Even if you just display them, like, well, why do you keep them in a box? If you're not planning on selling them, what's the point? It defeats the purpose of even buying them all. So I did open up all my dolls and I'm going to show you all of them. Probably not all in this one video, but maybe I will do that. Maybe I will. I don't know. Okay, so I think I've gotten rid of everything that is trapping her. I usually bring the garbage over because I have a lot of trash here. The garbage is full. But no, I did not throw the boxes away. I did not throw the boxes away. I kept the boxes. I just flattened them out. I flattened them out because I like to keep the boxes because they're really nice sometimes. I don't keep all doll boxes, of course. Just the ones that I really like for if they're vintage or something. Did I get the things that was attached to her hair? Okay. Well, these things are connected to her hair. Get those off. I think I can lift her out now. No, something is still holding her into this thing. She's still got twist ties all over her body. Okay, let's see if I can pull her head out. Okay. I almost got her. Okay, she's got something that's holding her right here. It's like a piece of, I don't even see this through the back of the box. Okay. Out. She's got twist tie. This twist tie is in between her waist. So I'm not gonna mess with it too much. I'm just gonna cut it off. Right here at the dress. Her dress is attached to her hair. Gets to hold it up. I'm gonna pull her dress down. She's got a piece of plastic right here. And the straps, the original straps that was on her outfit are broken. Okay, she's got some stuff in her hair. Move this twist tie from her hair. And she's got pieces of fabric on her arms. Okay, the straps to her dress broke. So, she's beautiful. Fix her hair. You can see her. Okay, her leg is bent. Like, yeah, both her legs are bent for some reason. Unbend those. And she does not have to be under there. She's from 1993. I'll stop. And she's got this very big dress. It's very poofy. Very, very poofy. Look at it. So I'm gonna do this stand. Oh, okay. I was about to say, where are her shoes? I was about to freak out.
My name is Dorothy Britton. I'm a professional organizing expert, and I specialize in hoarding. How are you? I would say, being scared is kind of a little bit of a
her. See, like, her box I would keep because it's so nice. There's so much effort put into her box. Her dress is gonna stick up a little bit because it's been placed up there since 1993, so she's over 24 years old. She's got a little flower in her hair. And she's got this golden red dress. Her dress isn't adjustable.
This is really beautiful, y'all.
She's got these beautiful shiny flowers. Move the camera closer. She's got these beautiful shiny flowers with like beads. She's got beads all over the place. With the beautiful hair is kind of sticking out. She's got a few curls. She's got a little band around there. She's got dangly red and gold earrings. They're on a post and they dangle if they're placed correctly. The flowers are sewn to her bodice, which is falling down because of the straps that broke. And then she's got, these are the bands that are holding these flowers on her arms. And her dress is beautiful. So all I'm going to do is like a little view. She has long, soft blonde hair with the original rubber band, of course. She's brand new. And she has a flower. I'm going to kind of leave that alone so that I don't ruin it. And in her face, she has green eyeshadow. She's got green eyeshadow with green eyes, and she has gold over the, just above the green eyeshadow up here. There's green, and then there's gold up here. She's also got like a pink little mark in the middle of her eye. You can see that to make her eye look more realistic. She's got blush. She's got ruby red lipstick. And her bodice is golden, and it stops here. And then there's a layer. And then there's another layer. There's several layers, and then there's this bottom layer. And there's 1, 2, 3, 4 layers above each other, and it just creates this big, beautiful poof of a dress. She also has a ring. She has a golden ring to match her earrings. And it's a spooky dress. So I'm gonna sit her here. She's got a stain on her foot. I'm gonna assemble her stand, which is, her dress is covering the camera, so I'm gonna assemble her stand, which is just a, actually there's two other dolls that came with the stand. I should have made a video on those, but I just wanted to just open them by myself, you know, enjoy them. She's shedding glitter all over my table, just like Glitter Beach Steven did when I opened her. She's getting glitter all over the table. There's like golden glitter all over my table. And this is a very tiny table, so there's really not enough room for all of that. And she's just got a regular pair of red pumps, of course, to match. I just dropped her picture. Oh no, these are not regular. Oh wow, these have a little bow on the front. I just knocked her picture actually all the way over there. These pumps are different. These pumps, if you can see, these pumps have a bow on the front. Let me try to see if I can kind of cover so you can see. There's a bow on the front. Most Barbie pumps don't have that. I just had a feeling her shoes would be different. So I'm gonna actually tell you, I have a very tiny table. So I'm gonna move my camera. You can see the Barbie case in the back. I'm gonna move my camera back here. So I can have some room so you can see These are all stand. And her stand says, holidays, happy holidays, Barbie, special edition. She's a special edition doll. It didn't say she was limited to a store, it just says special edition. And you know, as you know, in the Barbie, in Barbie history, they made several holiday Barbies. Rio contains a type of medicine that increases the risk of death from asthma problems. It may increase the risk of hospitalization. This doll is amazing. So you can see her feet are actually showing a little more than I thought that they would. Okay. Your doctor will be a doctor Rio and prescribe a different asthma control medicine. Yeah, because her dress is kind of sticking up. Do not take Rio more than prescribed. See your doctor if your asthma does not improve or gets worse. So you can see her. She does come with a golden hairbrush, so you know, brush her hair, brush her little curls. So I'm gonna slide her over to the side. Because I said I was gonna show you those other dolls that I had gotten. These are the straps from her outfit. They broke, so there's no reason to keep them. So first I'll show you those dolls that I got that weren't, they were in the bag. These were loose dolls. These were just sitting in a basket and I happened to find them. And so I did get that stain off the dress. It was a red stain, if you remember. I got it off. And this is not her body. This is in 1987 Barbie and the Rockers doll. But I believe she has the first Barbie and the Rockers body, or she has another doll's body. I really can't tell you who the doll is right now. I did fix her neck. With some special type of gorilla super glue. I fixed the other doll as well. She just has a big crack. She still has that purse. This is her. I put her, the dress back on. This is the dress that I found her in, so I put her back in and she looks cute in it. Got her hair all combed out. And her hair was cut, just like my other Barbie the Rockers Barbie. Her hair has been cut before. I don't know why they only do this to these dolls. And she's wearing those shoes that I love so much. The shoes are awesome. And they actually match the dress, so I think that this was like a fashion. Maybe this is like a Barbie fashion. Because these shoes match. But I don't remember seeing a Barbie in this outfit. This purse doesn't match, but this is the purse that she had. But there's also the brush that matches this, so that also makes me believe that this was maybe either a Barbie was wearing this, or this was a fashion, but usually fashions don't come with brushes that match Barbie's do. Proof. So, I don't know. We'll sit it back over here. Here's the other one in my favorite dress. I really love this. I like that one too. Here she is. And if you guys know what Barbie this is, please tell me. See? I fixed her. Her head is a little loose, but you can see the crack there. Actually, I'm going to bring this a little closer. And if you guys know what doll this is, let me know. And she's got these, she's got these pumps on. It's regular Barbie pumps. And she's got this amazing Barbie fashion. This Barbie is, these are both genuine Barbie fashions because they have the tags in them. You can tell that this is a Barbie fashion because it has a B on it. Just had to fold it. There she is. Got her hair all fixed up and everything, so I'm gonna sit her over here. And I'm gonna do separate reviews on the other dolls that I got. So look forward to those videos coming today. See you guys next time.